Hello guys, this is Frames here. Today I am going to show you how to convert this video file into this image sequence right here. Or you could say that I am going to show you how to extract the frames from a video. So let's get started without wasting any time. We are going to use OpenCV to do this. So now we need to define some paths where our video files are and where we need the image sequence to be. So we will make two variables here called as video path, where this is the path of the parent folder of the video, right? We actually need the path of the video in two separate parts. Here, so the name of the video in a different variable and the path of the variable in a different variable, because it will be helpful for us to name our image sequence in a nice way later. So now we will define output path where our image sequence will be outputted, right? So now this is all the paths we need. Now what we actually need to do to import the video into the program is we will define another variable and set it as equal to cv2.videoCapture, right? Now this function takes the input as the full path of the video. So we will what we will do is we will just concatenate the two variables to get a full path here. Now that we have the video in the program, we will make a loop. We'll make a while loop so that it will capture each frame and output it, and then it will continue to the next frame. So we want to run this loop while the video is opened, right? There is a function for doing this. So now that we have checked if it is open, we will define another two variables here. And we'll set this equal to video.read. So this video.read function actually gives us two values. The first one is a boolean which will be true if the current frame of the video contains some data, and it will be false when there is no data. So to check that, so we will write a if statement. If the flag is false, we don't actually want to run this loop, and we can break out of it. So now that we have confirmed that the current frame contains some data, we can just write that image and save it into our folder. So this function takes in two inputs. The first one is the path and the second one is the image. The first input is the path where we want the image to be saved, and the second one is the actual image, right? The actual variable which contains the image. So the second one, we know that it is the frame variable. So for the first one, what we will do is as each image in our image sequence has the same parent folder, we can just use that. Wait, Let us change this. Yeah. So now that we have the same parent folder, now we can use the video name, but this video name, we are using this video name so that our image sequence will get the same name as the video, so it will be easier for us. So but the video name already contains the file extension of the video, right? So what we will do is split this at the dot. So now we have a list of two objects, so with the first one being the name of the video and the second one being the extension. We only want the first one, so what we will do is we will just only choose the first one, first index in the list. So now we have the name of the image, right? So but we want each successive frame to be numbered differently, right? So what we will do is we will add an underscore here for formatting sake, and then another what we can do is we can create a iterable variable so that on each iteration of the loop it will increase by 1. We start from round 1 here and then we will iterate it by adding 1 on every instance of the loop. So what we will do here is we can convert the I into a string and then add it to the file name of the image. So now every successive frame will be named as 1, then 2, then 3. So says this. So now this is the name of the image, but it has to have an extension, right? File extension. So we also need to add that. Don't miss this step. It is an important one. I'm choosing .jpg here. You can choose anything, .png or .jpg or something. So this is the entire code that we actually need. But to show that some progress is being currently made, we can print some statements here, image and then I, so that we will show which frame it is currently outputting. So when the program is finally done, when the loop is complete, we can just print that done converting or something to indicate that it is complete. So let's check if there's some errors. So okay, let us try. Okay, it's working. Let's go. As you can see, it is saying that it is done converting. Let's check. As you can see, the folder contains the image sequence and it has been named in a very nice way, so you can easily use it in our future. So that's it for today, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day. All the best.